This is Jack Wagner in Hollywood on the Silver Platter Show. My in-person guest, Howard Roberts, guitarist extraordinaire, as they would say. Our feature album is Whatever's Fair, and I have a delightful ballad here from Skyscraper. I'll only miss her when I think of her. Another of my personal favorites from this album. How do you like it, Howard?
I like it fine. That's really a nice little song.
Some good things coming out of that show, too.
Yes, there are.
Yeah. And, of course, you also had The Shadow of Your Smile, the Academy Award-winning song in this LP, which
yes,
played on
right.
other shows. Mm-hmm. You know, before we went on the air, you told me a very interesting and very cute story of how you really started to play the guitar. What, the thing that really got you interested in the guitar? I wonder if you'd tell us on the air.
Oh, that's a funny little story. You know how kids are. I watch my little kid, who's four, and he reminds me of this stuff sometimes. Yeah. Well, when I was about 7 years old, I was playing with a bunch of other little kids over at their house, and they were all kind of bragging about things, you know, like my tricycle's bigger than yours, and my daddy has a gun, and things like that, you know. And I hadn't come up with anything yet, so it was sort of my turn, and I was feeling the pressure of this thing. So I decided to tell him that I could play the guitar. Now, yeah. Where I got that, I don't know.
And you really couldn't?
I couldn't. No, I'd never touched a guitar before. And they said, well, strange you should mention that. We have a guitar in the corner here. Why don't you play for us? Well, under the tension of this thing, I pulled together quite a lot of energy, I guess, and I picked up this guitar. And I just made my hands go in every direction as fast as I could go, see? And I guess I kind of dazzled them with my footwork there, so when I was through, they didn't quite know if I could play or not. Yeah. And I was a little bit in doubt. I said, well, gee, maybe I can play the guitar after all.
And to this day, when they hear one of your records...
They still don't know.
That's fabulous. And then I guess, as I understand the story, when you were nine, you really started to play.
Yes, maybe that caused a little bit of the impetus that made me actually take up the instrument.
And did you ever study classical music?
Well, yes, I've always been interested in classical guitar. I have studied it off and on over the years, but there's something about the spontaneity of playing jazz and the excitement that you can get from experimenting with jazz is really more my style, I think.
Have you ever thought of taking a classical selection and doing an improvised chorus? Or an improvised version of it using the chord changes that would be involved?
Yes, I have considered that, although I find some of the music of Bartok, for example, mm-hmm. or Ravel, a little more interesting for that than some of the traditional guitar music.
Which doesn't lend itself really to that sort of thing.
Well, I guess it does. I just don't tend to think in that way. Uh-huh. I mean, most of the classical guitar music is kind of Spanish-oriented, mm-hmm. or Bach music, and much like that, all of which is beautiful, but it doesn't make me think mm-hmm. of improvising so much.
Well, let's improvise a little bit here on this song we were talking about a little while ago. From Skyscraper, I'll Only Miss Her When I Think of Her. Our guest, Howard Roberts, and the quartet from the album Whatever's Fair. Thank you.
I think usually find jazz to be a very intriguing area of study. It leaves you plenty of elbow room for exploring music on your own. It's not like you're tracking through music that had been written by someone else, but you're actually engaged directly with the business of creating melodies and harmonies on the spot. This feeling or this vent of creativity, if you're inclined in that direction, is a very inspiring and exciting thing to do.
Howard Roberts is not only the star of his own albums, but also one of the guitar players on many sessions that never credits Howard Roberts. And this is something that comes from being a schooled musician and being able to read music and play what's there, right, Howard?
Well, that's true. It's a very interesting line of work, actually. Doing studio work, doing professional recording like this, on call, you might say, I am brought into contact with the hottest talent going around. I do dates with, just to name a bass player, for example. I work with Red Mitchell, Ray Brown. I work with these people all the time, Shelly Min, on drums. Just the best in their field. The arrangers are magnificent. Oliver Nelson.
Well, you do a lot of motion picture scoring, too. I mean, you get calls from the studios, don't you? The
yes.
Contractors at the studios, when they want guitarists, chances are you're one of the first people that are called.
Yes, I do a lot of movie work, do a lot of television work, and recordings. Mm-hmm.
And it's strictly all written music. In other words, these calls are not... these calls are primarily for a schooled musician, not just to do a jazz session, right? In other words, you are not primarily identified as a jazz artist.
Well, that's the funny part of my work. I'm identified as different things in different areas. Like there's probably some people in Shreveport who think of me as a country western player.
Really?
Yeah, this is true. There are...
Well, have you done country albums?
Many albums, not using my name.
Yeah, but you play country music.
Yeah. Some people identify me as a jazz player, which is my main bag. Mm-hmm. That's really what I enjoy the most. I've played classical guitar on several movies and things like this. So, with doing this kind of work, you end up being many things to many men.
Mm-hmm.
They see you in different ways. Rhythm guitar, you see, electric guitar, rock and roll guitar, all this different stuff. And it all just goes to make the thing more interesting, actually.
Yeah.
It's a ball.
Now, you were influenced greatly by Charlie Christian, who is a guitarist with Benny Goodman, among other things.
Right.
Isn't that true? Well, you know, I just happened to be going through my files, and I found this old album. Do you have it?
No,
the Benny Goodman thing?
No, I don't have it.
You'll have to pardon my name on here. I wrote that in about 1950.
But I
brought that for you, and I want to give it to you if you want it. But it's a Charlie Christian Columbia album, an old one.
Oh, that's groovy.
And
since I can't use it on the air with the FM station I have, it's not, you know, the ultimate in high fidelity.
Right.
But I thought, gee, you know, I'll give it to you. You might get a kick out of hearing some
beautiful.
Of those old things.
That's beautiful.
But as Charlie Christian influenced you, you are in turn influencing many, many people, such as Carkey here, who is an organist, not a guitar player. But, I mean, you're influencing people who are not even guitarists, which is great.
Well, that's not unusual. I actually was influenced by other players very much. Almost any instrument can be an influence on your thinking when you're in jazz, because you're really talking about a form of composition, you see. And you're interested in the way lines move and rhythms are being handled and the way harmonies are being dealt with. So piano can be a great influence, saxophone, even singers.
But don't you agree, Howard, that being able to read music opens up a whole marvelous world, and that is really an important thing to being a musician?
Yes, it is, and one real big reason why it is because this is the one of the this is one of the methods of communications in music. It's
you can't always remember what you want to play. You got to write it
human
down.
Human beings are noted for having short memories. And being able to read music gives you access to several hundred years of genius that has gone on in the music field. And if we want to add anything to the heap, we should first know what we're dealing with. We should
That's
know
right.
what is going on. I'm often amazed at the view that some people have that music is only self-expression. All you have to do, like I saw some guys on TV last night breaking up a piano. Now, they were serious about...
You mean destroying it?
Destroying it with hammers. Now, they felt that this was a form of musical expression. They felt that they were playing the piano in a different way.
Would you believe that's how George Shearing started? Really, he was 2 years old. He was hitting the piano with a hammer to hear the notes. No kidding.
Well, at least he moved on to...
he went up to better things.
Yeah. But there is really more to it than that. There's more to it than just banging on the keys. There's been real genius engaged in music. And anyone who looks into a Beethoven sonata, for example, or the string quartets, and can walk out of there thinking that it's just a simple matter of self-expression has really missed a very big
That's
point.
Right. That's
because
right.
the structure is immaculate. The thinking... he worked for example, I guess it was Beethoven, worked for like 2 years on his first string quartet. And he gave it to a guy, and a year later wrote the guy a letter and said, send my string quartet back, I just found out how to write it.
No kidding.
Yeah.
That's marvelous.
But that's why reading music is, one of the reasons reading music is so doggone important, that you have, then you can sit down and read a book that took a guy 10 years, or 10 years to write, or 30 or 40 years
that's
of experience,
right.
and you can read the darn thing in a week.
That's right.
You know?
Sure. Well, Howard, thanks so much for taking it. I know I'm holding up from a photo session.
No, that's
but,
not important.
But it's great that you take time to talk to Carkey and the guys here at the school. And I know they'll have a lot of questions, and I'll try to answer them. I may be calling you on the phone once in a while to ask you. But I know you're very busy, and you got sessions almost every day for every record label in the country.
I'm not that busy.
Well,
I'm one of the most... exciting things that happens to me is young, interested guys. And that I don't want to ever lose touch with.
Oh, that's marvelous, Howard.
Yeah.
Well, I've gathered a bunch of silver platter interviews for Carkey, and I'm sure he'll enjoy hearing all the things that we've done together and the times that you brought the guitar, remember, and we talked about what was funky and all this jazz. Good. So we'll switch over to those right now. Thanks again, Howard.
Thanks, Jack. See you, Carkey.